Welcome to another episode of Kitchen Revelations. So today's video is not a recipe, instead I'm here to clear more doubts on baking. The previous video where I had uploaded common mistakes while baking a cake has become really popular, and I really thank all my subscribers for supporting me in this journey. A lot of people have been asking doubts and requesting me to put another video on bread baking. So points that we need to note while baking a bread, or the common mistakes that we do, I tried to cover all of them in this video. Still, if you have any doubts, please let me know in the comment section below. So without wasting much time, let's quickly get on to the video. So the first point to be noted is measurements. Baking is a science. So before starting with the baking process, it is necessary that you weigh your ingredients. Investment in a kitchen scale would be good for this purpose. Link for it will be given in the description box below. Second point to be noted is temperature. All the ingredients required for baking should be at room temperature. Now under this, I would like to stress on two important points. That is, first is butter. How to check whether butter is at room temperature? When you press butter and if it leaves a soft dent, it means it is perfect for baking purpose. Now the second thing would be regarding the liquid added for baking. Be it water or milk, it needs to be lukewarm. Now how to test that? When you dip your finger, you should be able to bear the heat, but at the same time, if it is warm, the liquid is at perfect temperature for the yeast to ferment. Another important point that we need to note is the temperature settings of your oven. Every oven is different. Generally, we have seen people recommending to bake recipes at 180 degrees Celsius, but in case of my oven, the recipe comes out perfect at 160 degrees Celsius. So it is important to know your oven really well. The next point would be salt and yeast. Salt and yeast should not be added together while kneading the dough. Salt, if added along with yeast, will kill it, hindering the dough to rise and proof. So all those who have watched my previous video of perfect bread recipe must have noted that I've added salt at a later stage. Please do watch that video if you have not yet seen. It is a foolproof recipe for perfect spongy elastic bread. I've also made a dough starter for that elastic texture in bread. Link for it will be given in the description box below. Now another important tip with respect to yeast is always use freshly manufactured dated yeast and not expired ones. Live yeast will begin to bubble and react within 5 to 10 minutes. Dead yeast will not produce any bubbles at all and the liquid will appear stagnant. So this is a test on how you should check if your yeast is fresh or not. Another query asked was like the bread had yeasty smell and aftertaste. For this, you need to weigh the yeast demanded in the recipe on a weighing scale accurately in grams. Too much yeast will result in that yeasty smell, or if you over ferment the dough, that too also will result in this problem. For the brand of yeast and flour that I've used in the bread recipe, please watch the bread recipe video uploaded on this YouTube channel. Now the next step to remember, how to test your dough, whether it is perfect or not. Though you would measure the ingredients properly, the end result would not be the desired one. This depends on various factors. For example, if you have added too much liquid, be it water or milk, it will result in a sticky dough. The dough will not hold shape and it will result in a flat bread. In case of flour, always use good quality flour for baking. Some flours require more liquid as compared to the quantity mentioned in the recipe. This might be just an addition of one or two more spoons, not too much. However, this judgment is left to the discernment of the baker. If you add less liquid or if you keep on adding more flour while kneading to get rid of that sticky texture, the dough will dry out and it will result in a crumpled bread. Regarding sticky texture of the dough, you might feel like the dough is super sticky initially, but kneading it for a good amount of 10 minutes will solve that problem. That is called the window pane test. You can actually see through the stretched elastic dough. This test was before proofing the dough. After proofing, there is one more test wherein you can check whether the dough is a success or not. Poke your dough after proofing. If it is not regaining its shape or not filling the punched hole, it means that your dough is perfect. Please check my bread recipe video wherein I have explained how to knead and proof the dough very well. Kneading the dough for 10 minutes will release the protein called gluten, which is responsible for that silky, soft and cushion-like texture to your dough. Hence, it is important that you keep your laziness away while kneading the dough, and that is why people stress on kneading your dough for 10 to 15 minutes. Once dough is ready, it will become stretchy and elastic and it will not stick to the surface anymore. The next point to be noted is kneading. I've already explained a lot of times that you need to knead the dough properly at least minimum for 10 minutes, that is between 10 to 15 minutes. An underkneaded dough doesn't spring as much as in the oven, resulting in a flat-looking loaf with a dense texture. It may also tear when you try to cut the slices. So before first proofing, it is important that you knead the dough at least for 10 to 15 minutes. Now before the second proofing also, you need to knead the dough, but here you need to be careful. You do not need to knead too much as you have done for the first proofing. Once the dough doubles in size, grease your palm with oil, punch the dough and knead lightly for a minute. Overkneading at this stage will result in a flat bread, but it is very necessary to punch down the dough properly, otherwise there will be large holes in the bread slices. So kneading before second proofing is just meant to degas the dough, that you need to keep in mind. The next point would be covering the dough. You might find this point silly, but if the dough is not covered properly and if it is exposed to air, it will form a layer or skin on top of the dough which will make it difficult for it to proof and rise. A cling wrap would be best to cover your dough. At the same time, if you don't have a cling wrap, a one-time investment in a good shower cap would be good because you can reuse the same every time you bake. Also, every time before covering the dough, apply some oil on top so that the dough doesn't dry out quickly. The seventh point would be greasing the tin. It is necessary that you grease your baking tin generously with oil or butter. This step is important to get a nice brown color on the sides of the bread loaf. Now the points to be noted for a soft and shiny bread crust are, you need to give egg or milk wash before baking. After baking, immediately apply some oil on top of the bread crust and immediately cover it with a damp cloth. Applying butter will help in giving a shine to the crust. At the same time, covering it with a damp cloth will soften it. Another question which most of them have asked is regarding demolding. When to demold and how long should you keep the baked food inside the tin? After baking, wait for 10 to 15 minutes before unmolding the bread from the tin. Now why you should wait? This is because the cooking and the cooling process is still going on and we need to give time for the bread to set. At the same time, if you keep for more than 15 minutes, it will result in a soggy bottom. So demold your bread loaf after 15 minutes. The next point is cooling. A frequently asked question like, how long does my bread take to cool? When can I cut the bread into slices? After demolding your bread, allow the bread to cool on a wire rack for at least 1 hour. Now, even while the bread is cooling, you should ensure that it is covered with a damp cloth so that the bread doesn't dry out. Now, some other points like, you should not keep on opening the oven door frequently. To keep on opening the oven door, it will hinder the rising and baking process and it will result in a flat bread and soft crust. Also, some other points like, underkneading the dough will result in dense and shapeless bread, while overkneading will result in dry and crumbly bread. I hope I've been able to cover almost all the points related to bread baking. Still, if you have any more doubts, please let me know in the comment section below. If you're new to this channel, please don't forget to subscribe and thank you for watching Kitchen Revelations.